Maps, the things in ARK you play on. There's 9 of them now, with a 10th soon to join the roster. All of which I ran guides on quite recently, and then following that put it to a community vote on what you believe is the best map in ARK. You're right kids, it's Raasclark, and the following is the maps all ranked in order as per your votes, with me giving my take on why I believe you voted these in the places that they are. So, in at number 9, Scorched Earth. It's no surprise really. Scorched Earth is a hostile and ferocious map to live on. Not only are you battling the elements, with constant fatigue against your characters, and an unforgiving building meta where you can't build just in metal, as you'll overheat and die. With the intense heat weather effects making it so much worse, a lack of water, and not many great base locations. The dino levels are also pretty weak, with it being the worst scar to farm Wyvern eggs on. But it certainly has to be overlooked as one of the best for farming bosses and elements, with the boss requirements needing so little to face the Manticore. However, you voted it as the worst map in ARK. So let's move on to the next one. Number 8, the center. Why oh why oh why did you pick the center at such a low place? For me personally, it's my favorite map, I think. From a beginner level, it's really unique and a great place to hide away in early on, tame dinos on with the high RNG levels, and farming loot and artifacts with some easy locations for those. However, I speculate the center is perhaps underestimated in it, being perhaps a more simple map that perhaps players haven't looked into enough to understand how deep this map really goes. I can agree that running the boss on this map is a grind, the requirements are up there, but it has some fantastic base locations, some locations that are banned on unofficial servers, they're that good. However, you voted it as number 8, so in it goes. In at number 7, Genesis Part 1. I'm not surprised by this one being quite low. The map divided into the 5 biomes is just a bizarre entry really. I understand why it's a thing, but it just loses that fluid appeal that the other maps give. It's also certainly one of the more challenging maps, with almost every biome presenting you with some level of difficulty. But again, I think the mission system is overlooked. Yes, it's a grind to meet and beat the boss, but the loot you get from those missions far outweighs any other map. This is the only map you can gain tech swords so early in the game. But also, I can see the lack of flyers really hinders this as a map, and I hope Wildcard redeem themselves with Genesis Part 2. In at number 6, Valguero. Middle of the field, it's one of those. It's a decent enough map, but it just doesn't have that wow factor that some others do. And whilst I believe there are some good hidden base locations on this map, it just doesn't seem to be one that appeals to most to start on and survive on. Overlooked, of course, the boss on Valguero offers you 3 times the opportunity to unlock a bunch of tech engrams. It certainly missed the shot with the Wyvern Scar being fire and ice, the weaker Wyvern entries of all of the Wyverns. And I think if they swapped out those for lightning and poison Wyverns, and perhaps implemented more aberration creatures to the map, I could certainly see this ranking a little bit more higher. In at number 5, Extinction, middle of the ground. It's a great map early on to start farming tech and element on, with some great hidden base locations, but a very, very, very different map to all the others in how it's tackled. Drops are gone, so your quest for loot is in the form of missions, OSDs, horde missions, where you'll have to defend against wave upon wave upon wave, making this a much harder map for loot early on. But once conquered, you can certainly farm a wealth in this map. And that's not even looking at the titans that you can tame and the unique creatures it offers. In at number 4, Crystal Isles, the latest mod map to come to ARK. Having played it a bit now, I can agree with it being somewhere near the top. It offers almost all of the official map creatures and items, with a wealth of biomes being the biggest map and plenty of places to build and survive on. It also introduced a new flavour of Wyverns that a lot of people like to use now. and a huge scar full of griffins, and easy mats to farm, including element shards, so it's no surprise it being so high on the list. In at number 3, the island, the OG, the original map that came to ARK. I can see this being up there because it is one that we all fondly remember, and we all probably played on this one, especially as it's the base game offering, meaning most players may have only played this map and none of us. But it's definitely a difficult map to survive on compared to the others. The bosses are certainly challenging, and most of the artifact caves are tough to run. And resource gathering isn't the best in comparison to other maps, although it's certainly the one to farm cementing paste on. But the memory lane trip definitely puts this up into third place. In at number 2, Aberration. It's great to see Aberration so high on the list. I wouldn't personally rank it as high, being such a difficult map to a lot of players, but it's such a unique cool map. Being totally underground and not having flyers, it still offers a variety of creatures and new ways to tackle ARK. The whole light versus nameless and reaper system, the rock drakes, basilisks, crabs, the surface where it has its own unique night cycle, the earthquake system. There's a lot of cool features this map brought, and it's great to see a lot of people rank this so high, although I think they're forgetting the nightmare to transfer off. Although I've got a guide on that and you can check a link in the description. So that leaves only one more. Number 1, Ragnarok. Here it is, the original multi-map map. Why? Because it was the first map to integrate two different story maps, being of course the island and Scorched Earth. It introduced the griffins and an easier way to farm wyverns. But beyond that, it's a nice, easy map to start on. There's plenty of very cool base locations to build on. Resources are plentiful, and the unique gauntlet missions you can do with the Ice Queen, the Lava Golem, and the Labyrinth, as well as some easy artifacts, all come together to make this one of the best maps out there. But there's certainly a negative side to this. Because it's the most favoured means there's going to be more trolls in PvP on this map than any other map. So definitely bear that in mind if you plan to play this in PvP. I personally would not build on Ragnarok, however, from a PvE standing, I can definitely see the attraction to the map. And that's it, that's my breakdown of your votes at the best ranked maps in ARK Survival Evolved. Until Genesis Part 2 comes out, I really hope that's going to be a bit of a game changer in what it offers. Being set on a spaceship alone is just a whole new ballpark. But at least you know if you want to build somewhere hidden, pick one of the ones that are ranked lower. As I mentioned before, I've done survivor guides on every single one of these maps. So go and check my tips playlist, they're all there for you to use if you want to learn about any of these maps. My name's Raasclark, don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and as always, peace out.